मिसेस कमला बाला सुब्रमण्यम, आप अपना इंट्रोडक्शन दीजिए, किस स्कूल से हैं और आप लड़कियों के लिए क्या कर रहे हैं?
गुड आफ्टरनून, कुलकर्णी साहब फ्रॉम ऑब्जर्वेशन रिसर्च फाउंडेशन मुंबई एंड शबिस्तान, माय गुड फ्रेंड हुम आई मेट इन दिल्ली इन अ वर्कशॉप अबाउट 2 years बिफोर and was much impressed by the work that she's doing, especially to empower the women. I'm very happy to be here on your call. And all my fellow leaders, friends, representatives from the government, the administrators of the schools, colleges, Nizmaji, who is also a very great leader, doing a good work. My president, a visionary leader, Mr. Aslam Faqi sir, who is seated here and who is instrumental for me to come here. He is the president of the Konkan Muslim Education Society. Sir, you could raise your hand so that people could see. And Professor Taranam Sheikh, who is my fellow colleague working in the Department of Physics in a very committed manner. And Sir Ashraf, Sir Afroz, G and all friends, it was very nice to start with to see the documentary film created by the Observation Research Foundation. I personally, as a teacher, as a human being, it gave me to reflect like what I'm doing, whether I could do further more. You know, that was really very inspiring. And the film also was screened very nicely, beautifully. So my compliments for the entire team, because I know it will go maybe the whole country and the whole world. I'm sure it's going to motivate. The very intention is not to say what he's doing, the good work, but to inspire others also so that we could continue to do the good work. And Madam Abida ji spoke earlier, and we are very much aware of Azam campus, what are the good work that is going on under the able leadership of Mr. Inamdar ji. And we also have collaborated along with our chairman, Mr. Aslam Faqi, with the Azam campus and do a lot of good work. I'm talking about the Konkan Muslim Education Society, which has been established in 1927. And almost more than 85 years, 87th year is running. And earlier, maybe the visionary leaders, Mr. Mustafa Faqi, who is the uncle of Mr. Aslam Faqi, and great visionary leaders like Mr. Murtaza Faqi, and very many leaders, thought that in Bhiwandi, they must start the educational institution. So the Rice High School, which is there in Bhiwandi, has completed more than 85 years and produced a lot of educationists and leaders in this country as well as in the whole world. And I am very fortunate to be there as the principal of Konkan Muslim Education Society's GM Women Women's College. This college exclusively for the women to empower the girls, the education, and it has been established in 1989. We completed Silver Jubilee year last year. This is the 26th year that the college is running. And I'm very happy because of the complete teamwork, the excellence, the commitment of the management and all my heads of the departments, the teachers, all the stakeholders. We are excelling very well. We got from the NAC the A grade. We received the best college award from the University of Mumbai. And we also got recently during this year from the government of Maharashtra an award for spreading a lot of social awareness to the citizens. So we are indeed happy that under the vision of the management, the college is doing very well. With these few words, Because when I was told by Sabista ji, you said that you talk about the healthy practices so that everybody could know what is good work that is going on. And then we can talk about the challenges so that we could recommend that to the government and we could see that how the minority commission could work towards the welfare of the minorities. That is very important. About the healthy practices in our college, Momin Women's College, Ghulam Mohammed Momin Women's College, that we normally take the students after admission, we immediately conduct an orientation program. Because it is very important to orient the parents also to ensure that the girls are not coming simply to get a degree till they get a proper match and get married. Sometimes that is the mindset in Bhiwandi. So we decided with the permission of the management and with the encourage of the management, we normally every year in the beginning we have an orientation program where we call the parents of every single student and 100% attendance that we have, and we address the parents class wise along with the students. And when we talk to them about what that we are doing and what we expect from them, the cooperation with regard to attendance, with regard to discipline, with regard to their counseling and their observation at home, all that really works out very well. So we have this beginning an orientation program with the parents. And immediately after the first term examination in the month of November, we again hold a parents' meeting. And that time we communicate to the freshers that whether they are doing on the right path, whether they are going on the right line, or whether they are slow learners, or whether they need furthermore attention from the parents' side or from the teachers' side. So the first healthy practice is the collaboration with the parents, taking their support and ensure that they are also cooperating with us to see that their students are doing very well. So that is the first practice, the healthy practice that we are adopting here. Earlier, the parents never used to turn to the college. I'm there in the college right from 2000. I've completed 14 years. And this is a very successful story I could tell. And management also has implemented in all the other schools run by the Konkan Muslim Education Society. This parents' interaction is beautifully working out. So that is the first healthy practice I'm sure many of you would be doing. It may be not very new, but I thought I would share what we are doing, the good work. And second, academically, it is not that our college is taking all the cream. We are normally taking even the students with 35%. Afroj ji was telling that you are going to Ismail Yusuf College. You are very sure, sir, you are most welcome to Bhiwandi also, to the college. Maybe we need to take care later part in the challenges I would come across what the government could do though that, so that the girls can even come to Bhiwandi and study from our college. So the students whom we are taking, they are not the cream. They are with a 35%. And they are with the average students position they are coming. But I must tell you, we normally take care with the cooperation of the teachers, committed teachers. We do conduct a lot of tests which are not required as per the university norms. Almost after every chapter we conduct the test and ensure that the students' progress is being monitored very closely. And because we are doing a very close follow-up, our students, though they join with 35% or 40% or 50%, some of the students, maybe 5% of the students, the cream of the students are also joined there. And we are in a position to ensure that when the students are leaving out of the college, normally if they've got HSE percentage about 35, they go with at least 10% of increase. So this is the good work that the college is doing. That is mainly because of the commitment of the teachers. I hope I'm given 5 minutes so that I should be very quick in my sharing. Okay, so that is a practice which we are doing. The second practice is the constant vigilance, the supervision, monitoring, counseling and guidance of the teachers along with the students and testing, which gives the performance in a better manner. So that is the second practice. And thirdly, we felt that it is not the academic excellence alone is going to help them. They must have also certain kind of a skill development. So we ensured that through the Department of Botany, along with the curriculum, of course, our chairman, sir, Mr. Aslam Faqi, it is his brainchild, I would say, that he said that you must start an innovative club in your college. In all the institutions of the Konkan Muslim Education Society, we started an innovative club. And under the innovative club, we encourage the teachers to come out with certain kind of innovations. So Department of Botany, they installed like SEED club, that is socio-economic empowerment program and development. So under this, the students, along with the curriculum, they are taught how they could make certain things out of the waste, they can make, they can sell. So they made like handbags, they made certain jewelries from the pearls or from whatever is there, and they made certain kind of the decorative work, the interior designing, the candle making, the chocolates they prepared, they learned in the laboratory. All these, when they make, they go and sell, they get the profit. And we also developed the students to have certain kind of social responsibility. So therefore, the students, when they got the income, that income they shared for their own development. Certain 10% of the profit they have given to a student who is very poor to pay their fees. So that was a very good social responsibility which could come out with the innovation, with the commitment of the teachers and the students. Also on a teacher's day, in front of the very big celebration, they said that we are giving you, donating this profit what we earned, and that you must, madam, please give it to the poor students. So this is another practice which we are doing. And we are also conducting a lot of income generating courses under the NSS unit, under the Extension Education unit of the college. And where mehendi designing, which is normally for the wedding, they go, and even the beauty parlor, like we didn't know, we didn't have, but then some of the girls who learned the beautification courses, they are conducting the courses for the other girls also. So therefore, when during wedding season, they go and earn money. So therefore, they are in a position to at least pay the fees or buy the books or whatever that they want to do in the education, they are able to do. And this kind of a skill development courses along with the academic excellence is really doing very well. So I think another 2 minutes I'll just take and complete it. Madam, the challenges, I think, is very important. What you said to speak on certain points, that is the dropouts. We do have dropouts, about 10%. Earlier it was 20%. With all this good work, that dropout rate is reduced, and still it is about 10%. So what are we going to do? Like, how we are going to work on the dropouts? Because especially the Muslim girls, they get married even when they are in the first year, in the second year, when a good match comes. So we do the counseling with the parents and ensure even after the marriage, they must continue the studies. But still, that is a real genuine concern. So how are we going to work out for them, the dropouts? And I feel that we must also recommend to the government whether a kind of bus arrangement could be made. Because sometimes the students coming from a little far off places, maybe now if sir is sending from Jogeshwari to Bhiwandi, how are they going to come? The girls, the college is doing very well. And if they want to come, whether the bus arrangement could be made, whether they could be given on a very subsidiary kind of a ticket, maybe 1 rupee per ticket, wherever they want to travel. So that kind of a suggestion is from my side. And the students need to be, another challenge is the PG courses. We run a lot of PG courses in our college, but I find that the students are not joining the PG courses. Only about 5% of the students are joining. So I think we need to also see whether some kind of funds could be there for both PhD program as well as the PG program, so that the government should help the students and how we could get the funds. Another problem is the placement problem, because I think the government should tell TCS has come and placed our students, but I think not routine that they are coming. So therefore, the Infosys, TCS and some companies should be called, and the Muslim girls, those who are doing very well, they must be placed, and that should be mandatory for the companies that we must do. We must tell, I think. And the funding of various research projects, whether the government could help, that also need to be looked. And the government also could think of giving certain kind of funds and sponsorship, so that the girls, those who are doing very well, whether they could be sponsored, they could go at the national, international summit. I feel even this kind of a seminar, if you would have invited the girls, these students, because I think the students are the customers and we must orient towards them, the excellence, and we should not exclude them, we should include them. So any deliberations, whichever is made, I feel that you must invite from every institution, the students also, the customers, and which would might maybe improve. So I think the government need to work on the sponsorship for the international summit and the seminars and the conferences where students and the teachers could go. So I think these are things which I want in short to tell. And I must tell, despite of all these students coming from a very poor families and they are coming with a less percentage. Despite of it, I must, with a pride in front of my management, must tell that in Mumbai University, for 6 consecutive years, that our student was selected as the member of the Student Council of University of Mumbai. More than 4 lakhs of students, but 6 consecutive years, right from 2000 to 2014, 6 students, it is because of the leadership training that we have given through varied platform that they could go into that. And 2 students were as the student secretary, elected so meritoriously. So students, Muslim girls, the minority girls are very intelligent, as Abida Madam said. There are very opportunities to be given, the platform, the encouragement should be given. I think we need to encourage, and the government policy also need to be changed. It should be more friendly, and management is very keen that we must get the post-matric scholarship. So we are getting, last year we got about 25 lakhs of post-matric scholarship for the students. As Madam said, there should be a way out how we could fill up and how we could encourage the students to fill up. So the scholarship that need to look into, how it could be simplified and how the students can get the scholarship, that is very important. And students also were in the merit list, as Madam said. I have not brought up the presentation, PowerPoint presentation, but almost every year that our students figured in the university merit list. I must tell, Professor Tarannum Sheikh from the Department of Physics produced 2 years, I think it was in 2006, she produced university first rank, second rank, third rank. And all 3 rank holders of University of Mumbai came to our college. And even from the Department of IT, Department of Botany, everywhere we produce. And in MSc Zoology, our girl from Bhiwandi got the gold medal 2 years before in MSc Zoology. So we're academically doing well, and I think we need to look and deliberate after lunch maybe on the challenges, Madam. Thank you very much.
Thank you
for
so
considering
much,
and giving me the time.
I'm aware
thank
about
you.
Your work, or your college work.